So Google has launched its 2.0 AI models, and today they are introducing 2.0 Pro Experimental, 2.0 Flashlight, and 2.0 Flash Thinking Experimental. So all these models are live now, and it can be used by using the Google AI Studio. So in this video, we are going to test the Gemini 2.0 Pro Experimental model, and I'm having here a lot of prompts to test it. So to use this, just Google AI Studio and sign in with your Google account. Automatically you will be getting an interface like this. And here, if you click this, you'll be having a drop down and just select on Gemini 2.0 Pro Experimental. And here we can ask prompt, and it has 2 million input tokens. So that's really, really large. So let's just go with our first problem. So this is the math problem I'm going with. When I pasted this problem in O3 mini, it couldn't give the right answer. So let's see if this Gemini 2.0 Pro can do it. And this is how I'm pasting it. Hope it can like parse it and get the right equation. So it has given me the answer as -3/4, but the right answer is -3, which is B. So the reason why it has given us the wrong answer here is because it has interpreted the equation wrongly. Since it has like this, it's not aligned properly. It has interpreted the equation in a wrong way. As you can see here, it has given -8/x, but here it's -8x-3. So it has like interpreted the equation in a wrong way. But when I pasted the exact same question in the same aligned way in DeepSeek V3 and R1, it was able to give the right answer. So let's give it a second chance. This time I'm just going to get a screenshot of this equation, okay? So that would be, I guess, easy for it to interpret. So I'm just going and just screenshotting it. Maybe I can just copy paste, I guess. Yeah. So I'm just going to solve this. Yeah, and this time it has got the right answer. The answer is -3. Yeah, this time it's spot on. So in case if you aren't able to get the answer by copy pasting the equation, you can just give it a screenshot. So next, let's go with some coding problems. So first one, let's go with this bouncing ball problem. So it's going to be a HTML, JavaScript and CSS code where a rectangle will be spinning and a ball will be bouncing inside it. So it needs to get affected by gravity and friction. So let's just go and give this. So that was so fast for it to give the response. Like it immediately gave us the response. And let me just download this. Yeah, it has got downloaded as a HTML file, and open it. And the ball is going outside. Yeah, we actually faced the exact same problem in DeepSeek, but O3 mini model was able to do this. So the ball can't get outside the rectangle because in the prompt we have clearly mentioned, right, the ball should be affected by gravity and should be inside a spinning rectangle. So this is like, I would rate this like 60 out of 100, but still not the best. Okay, so next let's go with another prompt, and this one is going to be just a simple one. Just give the text United Top Tech in a beautiful and elegant font with some animation. So a simple one. I hope Gemini can do this well. So I'm just going here. We have got the code, and use Google Fonts. I think it hasn't. Okay, it has given the Google font. Okay, fine. So download this and open it. Okay, that's good. That's really amazing. Okay, finally Gemini has impressed me. That looks good. I swear that's a good text effect, to be honest. Yeah, maybe it can like refresh automatically, but it just goes in the corner. But still, that's a good effect, to be honest. So yeah, that's a good one from Gemini over there. And final prompt that I'm having here is, this is going to be interesting. This is a rain with a lightning effect continuously occurring in the background. So yeah, so the realism matters here. So I'll just run, and if we download this and open. Okay, we have got the rain. Okay, I don't see any traces of lightning at all. Wait, did I give lightning in the prompt? Yeah, I've given lightning, but I don't see any traces of, okay, we have got the lightning. We have got a blinking lightning. That's only once. Yeah, but the O3 mini model generated a hyper realistic lightning. Like it would be like zigzag thing, right? O3 mini model literally generated that, but here I just saw only one blink lightning. So in my opinion, out of the four prompts that we gave, it was able to perform two prompts like super well, and one of the prompts was due to misparsing of the question, but apart from that, it kinda does the job. I hope you'd have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.